Hi guys, this is Sai Kumar Kortiwada. In this video, we will learn about template-driven form validations. I have discussed few of the required properties for validating the elements of HTML using template-driven in my previous video. Please try to watch before going further in this video. Let me quickly jump into Visual Studio Code. Here, our target to understand about the validations of a template-driven form can be explained briefly by using three elements over the form. First one, username, password, and then we'll go with gender and a button with a label called as register. So based on that form, we will be validating the required fields as well as the patterns which are used over the username and the password along with the submit button. For that sake, let me create a default HTML form for these particular fields. Form. And inside this form, let me create one input field. And inside this input field, let me give a placeholder as username. And then I'll give a name as username. So these are my first field. And let me break this statement for the two times so that it will give the two line space. And let me use one more input with a placeholder as password. And then name as password. So these are my two fields, and let me create one more field which is a drop down. So we can use a tag called as select, and inside the select I can give a name as gender, and also it has two options. One option is male and the next option is female. Let me give option female, and now let me save this and run this application by using ng-serve. By the time it completes the compilation, let me create one object for two-way binding. Register obj is equal to with a username field as empty and the password field as empty and gender field as empty by default. So let me give semicolon. Now I have created an object in my TS, and let me map this object with my elements by using a ng-model. To understand about ng-model, please watch my ng-model two-way binding video in the same tutorial. Ng-model equal to, I'll use this object name, that is register object dot username, and let me give one more ng-model here. Ng-model equal to register object dot password, and let me create ng-model here in the select one. For the select one, we use a gender. And to use this ng-model, as we discussed in the previous videos, it has to be handled with a module. So if you go to the app module, I have already injected forms module in my previous video itself. So forms module is necessary to use our ng-model. It has been compiled successfully. Let me go to the browser. And if you reload this, we got username and the password. Let me zoom this and let me open the inspect. So here we don't have a button which is a register button. So let me create a register button now. So let me go back and create a break statements of two break statements, and then let me write a button with a type as submit. So I have submit button which is having a register label. So let me save this. Now we have our default HTML which is binded with a two-way binding in our HTML. Now whenever I enter some value in this username and the password, that will be injected into our register object as they are injected with ng-model. So what I'll do is, I'll create two values for this, male and female. When the user selects this female, it will be using this value and storing that particular value inside our register object. Let me save this. And now what I'll do is, I'll create one ng-submit. So whenever the user clicks on the register button, I'll trigger this ng-submit where the register method will be called. Let me define this register method in my component.ts. Let me go to the component.ts, and inside this, let me console the console.log of this dot register object. Let me save this and let me close this module and let me save HTML, go back. Now our target is whenever I enter username and the password along with the field which is male or female and clicking on the register, I need to see the console. Let me write some sai@gmail.com. So this is my Gmail, and let me give the password something 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, and let me select male and click on register. If you see here, we got a male 1 2 3 4 and sai at gmail.com. That means our two-way data binding is working as expected. Let me go back. Now what I want to do is, here the register button is not disabled when I am not entering these values, and when I click on the register, now you are getting a default values. Actually speaking, until unless the user enters username and the password along with the gender, this should not be enabled. So to validate this, we will be using some properties of HTML. First one is, let me use a required property, and this is also a required one, and let me use one more thing called as required. And also what I'll do is, I'll create an element for this particular form by using hash. So let me create hash form, or let me go with a register form, which is equivalent to our ng form. So we have ng form, and this register form can be used to disable our particular button. For example, we have a property binding called as disabled equal to, I can give this register form dot invalid. Whenever there is a registration form is invalid, it has to be disabled. Let me go back, and if you see here, that register is disabled. Let me enter some values inside this username, sai@gmail.com, and let me give the password, and let me give the mail. So if you see here, it has been enabled. That means we gave three validations. One is username is required, password is required, and the gender is also required. Whenever I enter all the required fields, the register button is getting enabled. But here the problem is, if the user does not enter some value, then the user cannot understand why this register button is disabled. So for that sake, we have to show an appropriate user friendly messages where he need to understand why that register button is disabled. So now for that case, what I'll do is, I'll bound this input field inside a div, where inside that div itself, we'll try to write all our validations. So let me write a div inside this, and for this div, let me use a span. And also this field is required. So we are showing this field is required, but when we have to show this, when the user value is invalid, that means the input value is invalid. So for that sake, for a specific element check, we will be using a element reference name. Name is equal to ng model. I am saying that this element is acting as a ng model. So I can use this name reference like star ng if is equal to name dot invalid when this name is invalid. And also we have to check whether the name is touched or not, or name is dirty or not. I have discussed all these invalid, dirty, touched properties in my previous video. Please watch for better understanding. So now let me save this. Now when the name is invalid, and whenever I touch or make any changes to this particular element, this particular field will be showing required or not. Let me go back, and if you see here, I'm trying to type something. This field is required. That means I didn't wrote anything and that field is required. So let me type something. Yeah, now you can see there is no message which is displayed inside this particular error messages, because the required field is valid now. So I have entered some value, so there is no error happening inside that particular field. Let me use the same concept for my password. So let me give a div, and let me cut this div and wrap inside this particular input field and format this. Now what I'll do is, let me copy this same thing, but now the difference will be changed. So hash password equal to, this is also a type of ng model, and let me refer to my ng model of this particular element, and let me change this name to password password and save this. In the same way, I will write this particular select as well. Let me write one div and wrap this select inside the div and then format. Now what I will do is, I'll try to write this particular div after this select, and let me refer this particular select one. Let me use hash gender is equal to, this is also referring to my ng model. So now I can copy this gender and pass here, here, here. So this field is required, save this. Now if you go back and let me click like this, this field is required, this field is required, and this field is also required. You can see all the error messages. Now what I'll do is I'll try to enter username, password and the field, then this register button will be enabled. Let me type something like @gmail.com and 123456. These fields has been filled and now I'm filling this one also. So if you see here, the all the error messages not showing in my HTML content. And whenever you remove this password, for example, again your field is required. So here we are doing a required validation and this register button is disabled when one of the field is invalid. So all the fields are valid, so it is showing the register enabled. Now what I want to do is I want to handle multiple error messages based on our different types of errors or different types of validations. For example, let me create two variables, that is a password pattern and the email pattern. Let me copy this, copy, and let me go to the TS file and paste here. I have already these patterns, just for time consistent, I have created already these two patterns for the password as well as the email, and let me save this. So now what I will do is I'll bind this email pattern to my pattern property. So pattern equal to this one, and it is a property binding which is coming from our TS, and also I am writing one more pattern here equal to my password pattern. What is my password pattern? Let me copy this and paste here, and let me make it as property binding and save this. Now for these two elements we have two validations, one is required validation and one is pattern validation. That means for this I am using a pattern where email is should be exist, and here I am using a pattern for the password where it should have minimum of 5 characters with one alphabet, one special character and one numeric value minimum. So now what I'll do is I have a property called as ng if, where we can validate only the required one, password.errors, and errors may be null, so we will be using a nullish operator. And now here we can use a required one. If it is having a errors with required pattern, then it will show this field is required. Otherwise, when the pattern is mismatched, then I'll show this field should have minimum of 5 characters and one alphabet, comma, one numeric, and at least one special character. Let me save this, and in the same way let me copy this and use above here, and in this span what I'll do is instead of password I'll use the name reference, and also here in this span I'll use ng if is equal to name dot errors dot required. Whenever this is required, it will show the required one. Whenever the pattern does not match, then this will be showing the pattern. So we can use please enter a valid email pattern. So now let me save this and go back. What I'll do is I'll try to touch this and come out. You will be seeing this field is required, and what I'll do is I'll try to enter the values now. Sai@gmail.com. If you see here, whenever I use abc@gmail till I enter a valid email pattern, it is showing please enter a valid email pattern. Let me use .co. So you may be having co or com that are valid, and it should not have one character after the dot. So that is the reason it is showing a valid pattern. Let me enter valid one, and now let me select one mail, and here what I'll do is inside the password let me enter abc, which is not a valid one, 123, it is having 6 characters, but @ now it is satisfying with alphabet, numeric and a special character. Now the register button is enabled. Let me click on the register and you can see all the values. So this is how we can do our front end validations by using template driven, by using the ng modal pattern. So here if you see, we did only two things. One is ng modal is referred with one of the element field, and that element field will have the properties like dirty, touched, errors or different types of properties which we have seen in the previous video. This is how we will be validating a forms using template driven. So this is a small example where we can use different types of validations over the different types of elements like email input element as well as a select element for our application. Thank you guys. If you like my video, please like, share, subscribe to my channel for more updates. Signing off. Thank you.